Hello and greetings from Iceland. My first volcano tour in 2025 has just started, or when I drove to Reykjavik last Friday, where I will be staying for a few days or maybe a couple of weeks to see how things turn out this time. Eruption number 11 could start any time now. So I've been shooting the so-called B4 footage, especially the lava berms, or to see how they have changed after the last eruption, how high they are now, and the impact on the landscape. And it's not complicated to see that the Blue Lagoon would not exist without them. And I will show you more of this soon, since I got a good day to do the B4 footage, but a bit too sunny to use the thermal drone this time. But I have it with me, and I will use it when I get the chance. But the tension here is rising, and I actually took off again to the volcano this morning, but it turned out to be a bit too windy, and the weather forecast for the next 3 days is as dull as it gets during winter in Iceland. Wet, windy, and limited visibility. So if the eruption starts in the next 3 days, that will be a problem. And the thing is that although I have all this footage from here since before this started, my collection lacks the first hours after the eruption starts, or the full curtains. And to capture such footage can be tricky as I'm living up in the north, several hours away. But this might be different this time. And I suspect that the eruption that we expect now will be similar as the last one. The main fissure opening has been developing to the north, where the magma has obviously the easiest path, judging from how little earthquake activity we get before eruptions now. And when I was filming from Grindavík last Saturday, there came two black smoke clouds from the crater. So for a while, I thought this was about to start, and I rushed out of the car with the drone. But since I hadn't used it for a while, I needed to log in to DJI. But first I had to put up a mobile hotspot in a hurry and reset one password to get everything going. So I only got the rest of the smoke there. And we are getting to the point where the media mentions every tiny earthquake around here. We got a few this morning, and I'm sticking to my old prediction and saying that the eruption will start this week. And after the eruption starts, we just have to hope that the lava berms will hold. They should do the job, but you can't be sure. The only thing I'm sure about now is that I can stay here until the 19th. Then I have to go north to undergo a small surgery to finish a little fix that started in December. And I'm told that I will recover very fast from the second one. So this is nothing serious, just volcano preparation. But the Met Office, they were however saying this morning that the eruption might not even start this month, although they kind of declared a state of emergency the other day. So the information that we are getting from them now are not very accurate. But the magma inflow has however slowed down, but it also did so before the last eruption and the eruption before that, or when the magma chamber under there is just about to fill up, or when the magma chamber under there seems to be just about to fill up, which seems to be the case now. So I can at least say for myself that I have the TV tuned on the webcams almost all day now when I'm working inside, and I'm of course leaving webcam links in the description. And if the eruption starts while I'm here in the south, the priority this time will be to capture the full curtains, but also of course to give you good information as soon as possible about where eruption number 11 will take us. And I suspect that it will be sooner than later. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.